happy day and welcome everybody. Welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living, Kelowna. How'd you get up this morning? Well, I woke up with my mind on spirit. Woke up this morning with my mind. Sing it out. Oh, woke up this morning with my mind. Stay. Hello, live streamers. Woke up this morning with my mind. Stay on spirit. Hallelujah. 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 Well, I'm walking and talking, yeah. Walking and talking with my mind. Won't you walk with me? You sound so good today, walking and talking with my mind. Are you singing at home? Yeah. Oh, 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 spirit, walking and talking with my mind. Stay on spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, I'm singing my song, yeah, singing my song with my mind. Oh, I'll sing to you. So good, yeah, singing my song with my mind. Stay, whoa, 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 spirit, singing my song with my mind. Stay on spirit, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, I woke up this morning, yeah, woke up this morning with my mind. Yes, I did. Stayed, I heard you. Oh, spirit, woke up this morning with my mind. Stay on spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I wanna do it one more time. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good morning, if you're willing. Stay with us as we let the love. We're talking about love today, friends. We're going to let it wash over us. Woo! Can you put your hands together? Here we go.
We let the love wash over us. We let it be. We let the joy, oh joy, come on now, joy. We let the joy wash over us. Joy, the peace. We let all the peace wash over us. We let, oh, we let it be. Bring it down with talk about some grace. We let the grace wash over. We let, come on, let it be. We let the love, oh, the love wash over us. We let it, oh, we let it be.
Stay right there if you're willing and you're able. I'm held in love. I'm held in grace. God is holding me. I'm going to ask Neal, our multi-instrumentalist, to step from one instrument over to the other. And to, yay, Neal. Come on, give him some love.
I'm held in love. I'm held in peace. God is holding me.
every step and every breath. With every step and every breath, God is holding me. God is holding me. Changes up here. God is holding me. God is holding me. God is holding me. God is holding me. I'm held in love. I'm held in love. I'm held in peace. God is holding. Play under us, Neal. If you're willing and if you're able to extend a hug, a kiss, a little check to the person next to you and say, good morning, happy day, and welcome. Welcome, my friend. I see you. Welcome. Hello at home, we see you. A little hip check. One more time. I'm held in love. I'm held in love. I'm held in peace. God is holding me. With every step and every breath, God is holding me. Have a seat, friends. Good morning and welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living, Kelowna. My name is Barbara Samuel. I am one of the many staff ministers and practitioners here to serve each and every one of you today. And along with my husband, we are co-musical and artistic directors. You have walked into the Center for Spiritual Living, and if you are here for the first time, you're settling into a Soul Food Sunday. What that means is it's how Spirit speaks through me, through music, through lyrics, through melody and harmonies. And it's not your conventional Sunday morning. I'm just going to say that's how we roll. And we're talking about love wins. No matter what you're going through, no matter what's happening in your life, no matter where you are, say it with me. Love wins. Hey, there's a lot going on in our beautiful community, and I want to tell you right from today, this afternoon, things that you can participate in and things that you can expect. Today is the Walk of Memories. It is downtown on Water Street, and it's at 2 o'clock, and it'll wrap up at the Dolphins at about 4 with the closing ceremony. And so the Walk of Memories, the Center for Spiritual Living Kelowna, is actually, we are part of the sponsorship and part of the collaboration along with the Kelowna General Hospital, the KGH Foundation, Springfield Funeral Home, McDonald's, and we are right there with the beautiful loved ones who are being sponsored. The Walk of Memories is an interactive, healthy, family-friendly way for communities to acknowledge the loss and remember those people that have gone before us. So Reverend Corrine is already hot on her feet down there this morning, setting things up with all of the volunteers that have come from the center. So if you are around, you go down to 1200 Water Street, which is the Dolphins, at 2 o'clock. And they will walk about a kilometer. And there are 4 stations where there will be music and speakers and a closing ceremony. Yeah, you'll go. You know why I know you'll go? Because we live downtown. And when I'm up on my balcony after church, I see you walking. I know you'll go. So we're all going to go. We live downtown. And so this Thursday, I want to keep you posted of things that are going on. That's this Thursday, September 28th, 6 p.m. Come a few minutes early, just if you can. 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the Royal Anne Hotel. We used to hold our services there, so everybody knows where that is, down on Bernard. And we are having Reverend Kathy, Dr. Hearns, doing our community co-creation session, where we are open to spirit to draw in and reveal the qualities of the person that we want to attract as our new staff minister. She is, I want to tell you about Dr. Kathy Hearns. She's a powerful teacher. She's a renowned speaker, and she has been actively involved in our greater organization, Centers for Spiritual Living and United Centers for Spiritual Living. And I have had the great honor of working closely with her as we have created our, in Kenya, our school of leadership. And she has nurtured us and loved us up. She is brilliant. She is amazing. And she's going to walk us through this moment. This whole weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday, but that's Thursday for you, 6 till 9. And then Sunday, she's going to be speaking here, right here at our center. And you want to bring your friends. She has been the sole female spiritual leader for the Abraham Path Projects. She travels to Turkey, Syria, Israel, Jordan. She founded the Pacific Church of Religious Science in San Diego, and she has her honorary doctorate within the Religious Science United Centers for Spiritual Living and International Centers for Spiritual Living. She is amazing. You don't want to miss her. You don't want to pass up having the opportunity to press her flesh as she's traveled to come and see us and spend her time and give her wisdom and her love to us. Take a breath. So we've got stuff to do tonight, Thursday, and Sunday, yes? And everything's online. Everything's there, and you can RSVP every single event. Then we know that you're going to be there. And if we're feeding you, we know what we're feeding you and how much we're feeding you. So RSVP. So I want to start, as we do all things in this teaching, to lay that foundation. The thing that sets us apart from every other faith, religion, is our spiritual mind treatment, a positive mind treatment. And I welcome to the stage Reverend Diane Hockey. Give her some love.
I am love smacked today. I read that somewhere, and I just had to use it. So please, I invite you to join me in that divine realm where spirit is, where love is, where all that's peaceful and joyful and easy lives. So I invite you to close your eyes and take my words as your own if you choose. There is one power, one presence, one divine creative energy in, through, around, and for everything, everyone, everywhere, all the time. I choose to call this one God, and it is also known as love. Yes. God is love. Yes. As I look out upon this congregation, I see love reflected back to me as I reflect it out to each and every person here. I know that this center is a beacon of love in the community, which radiates love out into our community, into our city, into the province, into the world, to the earth. I know that we make a powerful difference. And I know that this Soul Food Sunday feeds us more and more love to share. And so with a heart full of gratitude for knowing that there is only love, that the answer to every question is love, I simply release with gratitude my very powerful word back to the law, where the answer is always yes. I let go, and I do let God, and so it is.
And so it is. Thank you, Rev. Thank you. Neal, I think you should open us with one of my favorite songs that you do, since we're talking about love today.
Okay.
Join in.
There's a reason for the sunshine sky, and there's a reason why I'm feeling so high. Must be the season when that love light shines all around you. So let that feeling drive you deep into space and send you reeling with its loving embrace, and then go stealing through the moonlit night with your lover. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. Just let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love find you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. There's a reason for the warm, sweet nights, and there's a reason for the candle lights. Must be the season when that moonlight shines all around us. So let that feeling grab you deep inside and send you reeling where your love can't hide, and then go stealing through the moonlit night with your lover. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow like the smallest of dreams, and let your love flow, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. Just let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love find you through all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow like the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason.
Klassen, have a seat, friends, have a seat. I love looking around and seeing you all sing that song. It takes us right back, doesn't it? Just like Reverend Diane said, love is the question. No, whatever the question, love is the answer. That's what she said. Whatever the question, love is the answer. Love understands. It doesn't need any talk. So good morning, good evening, everyone, wherever you find us today. I'm here to tell you that love wins always, no matter what the situation, no matter what the condition, no matter what you're going through, love wins. As many of you know, I do lots of weddings throughout the year, and I always say to my couples that I get to be the fly on the wall for love. I get to witness love, and love in the most grand ways. And I truly consider that this is a privilege. This is people's glorious love day. I get to see people in their love in grandiose, in small and intimate, private and humble. I did 3 weddings last Saturday. I did 2 weddings yesterday. One was on a beach. One was, and it's personal to everybody, whatever anybody wants, explosive and dynamic, or sitting on a blanket on the beach, and there's just your loved ones with you. Here's the thread, love. And couples will ask me, no matter who they are, whether they're religious, non-religious, spiritual, don't believe in God at all, I'm often asked to read 1 Corinthians from the Bible. And it says, love is patient, love is kind, love does not envy or boast, it is not arrogant or rude, it does not insist on its way, it is not irritable or resentful, it does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Capital T, truth. This verse, I find, surmises all of what love means to folks. In our greater organization this month, International Centers for Spiritual Living, we have a theme that we try to follow that thread every month. And Neal and I are both so excited to share our favorite topic, love. Love, it's a short little word that can be used as a verb, as a noun, an adjective. It's everything. And in my opinion, love is the most powerful emotion and feeling that we can experience. Love can be the feeling of deep affection for another, Love can be romantic love, familial love, friendship love, community love, love that connects us to others and natures and helps us have that meaningful relationship in our life. I believe that love can heal everything and everyone, and that love lies forever in someone, even after they've transitioned. My mom, she's been gone since 1988. 1988, that's 36 years ago. And there is not one single day of my life that goes by that I don't think of a moment that we shared and that we got to express love. I was a young woman of 23. She was a young woman of 50. But I still remember that love, and I've got to tell you, it's here to stay. It's never diminished. It's never withered. It's never gone away. So to me, that tells me that love is timeless and never ending. But I want to tell you my foundation for love and where the ability to love one another despite deep circumstances or conditions come from. And can I tell you, I'm talking to myself today. So if you can glean any of this, that's wonderful. But this all is about me today. Love is a little word. It's also a short little word, but it's very powerful. But when I connect it to another very short, small, powerful word that goes by many names, that foundation or word is God, and that's what moves me. In the science of mind, and call God by whatever name you will, don't get caught up. It could be anything to you. Whatever that is, that higher power that resonates with you, goddess, God, spirit, universal love, one power, whatever that is for you. And in the science of mind, like Reverend Diane said, that word God is synonymous with love. Because God is all there is, well, love must be all there is, right? Absolutely. But as I say that, I'm looking around, and I see some of your minds might be flooded with thoughts of, yeah, but we're living in a world filled with war. Violence, division, stay focused on that one word. God, love. I gotta admit that sometimes in our lives we have challenges, we have struggles, we have strife, we have pain, we have confusion, all of it. And it may be challenging to see or know or remember that God or love resides behind the darkness of all of it. All of it. Today, because of these experiences, that we're invited to lean into love and express love out loud. This year for me personally has been hard. Personally, I have felt like I am in it. Is anybody else there with me? Holy moly. You know what I mean? There's family challenges. My daughter's struggling, and they say that a mother is only as happy as her most unhappy child. Mums? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you. So there's that, and there's financial challenges because we're helping out that family because they need some support. So, but I'm grateful that I have the money to be able to support because of that. I'm not working as much as I would like to, but I'm working too much at the same time. Do you know what I'm saying? So creatively, you know, I'm part of a band. So our band, Sister B and the Boys, we're looking for a new bass player, so I can't book as many gigs because I don't know what our future looks like. If you know a bass player, let me know. So creatively, we've kind of been stumped, right? Every quadrant of spirit, health, we went through some health stuff this year, wealth, creative expressions, relationships have been shook to the core. To the core. Friends, we're being invited to lean into love and express love out loud. In other words, lean into God. Lean into God, Barbara. And I guarantee that I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for love, for the love of our minister, for ministers reaching out, for the practitioners where we call and we say, do a prayer for me, for family, friends, colleagues, all of you. I come here and I transform. Because you are my love. You are my love dose. That's my love potion number 9. That's what you wanted to hear. Yes, we've been tired. We've been worn out and exhausted, scared, too busy, not busy enough, all of it. But my sense and my feeling and my commitment to love, to God, to faith, walks me through all of it. every single breath, every single step, and every single heartbeat, I know what is mine to do. What is mine to give? What is mine to do? All I want is to share myself with you. So I stand here asking, what can I do? What is mine to give? I'll give it to you. What is mine to give? What is mine to do? All I want is to share myself with you. What is mine to do? All I want is to share myself with you. So I stand here asking, what can I do? What is mine to give? I'll give it to you. Every day, all day, forever. We know this truth of love, yeah? So when I'm in it, thank you, Neal. When I'm in it, I ask myself the question, what is love here to teach me? What is mine to do? The truth is, love understands love. It don't need no talk. It don't need no proof, just recognition that it's there. That's all love needs. God is the answer to all the questions. God is the healing to the hardship, to the challenge. God is the space to transform the pain, yeah? And sometimes it's hard, but I believe we can change. And we actually are changing the world by leaning into love, by advocating for ourselves and each other's rights to express love in our own unique ways. And that, when we do that, it helps create a world that works for everyone. You know the answers. Say this with me. Say the word love and feel it at your heart. Love is God. God is love. And you've heard me say it before many, many times. Good morning, Paul. We welcome. We welcome you, sister. The universe don't make no mistakes. Reverend Corrine says it. I've heard Reverend Melody say it. Reverend Diane, my husband, tells me. And I know you go home and you believe it and you absorb that and you say, the universe does not make any mistakes. So love is no mistake. Every experience is unfolding for our highest and best for the entire world at large. For the entire world and our personal experiences too. Even those challenges that we're having. When we live from that place of understanding that love always wins, we consciously see how love is always unfolding right before us. Yeah? The science of mind says, and for those of you that are new to us and joining us, we practice the philosophy and the study of the science of mind, and the founder was Dr. Ernest Holmes. And he says that what we think about comes about. He espouses that what we think about comes about. And so here at the center, we don't teach you how to think, what to think. Go ahead and think what you want to think. We try to teach you how to think so that when you put before you your life, you're holding it in your own hands and you're co-creating that life with spirit, with the one. So the science of mind says the world's beginning to realize that it has learned all that it has through suffering and pain. Come on, friends. I don't believe that there is an intelligence in this universe that wishes anyone to be sick, have illness, suffer pain, be unhappy, or just fall into the oblivion. I don't believe that. I don't believe it. If God or universal intelligence is imbued with goodness, and I'm here to tell you it is, absolutely, then it cannot ordain that we ultimately can be anything other than the perfect expression of life and itself. We are mirrors of God in action. We are already perfect expressions of life. Take that in. You are perfect. You are perfect just the way you are. No matter what you're going through, no matter what your experience, you are held in love. You are held in grace. God is holding you. You are perfect, perfect expressions of God, Barbara. I'm talking to myself. Change or shift, whatever you wanted to call it, is simply an unlearning of the lessons of fear that have been passed down to each of us through generations. And when we live consciously from the understanding that love is all there is, we experience a life of love greater than we've ever known. Love wins. It's in the air. Every song writes about it. It's never wrong. It's all we need. It endures. It's forgiving. Love is all there is. God is all there is. My daily affirmations these last few weeks have been, I choose to remain conscious and aware of the presence of love. And I have been upset with people. I have had practice these weeks. I choose to remain conscious and aware of the presence of love. We were driving to church this morning, and I said to my husband, I don't like that person because there's some morning transactions happening before church. This is my holy, holy day. Why are people all up in me, right? Get up, get up, get off me. We had to sit in the parking lot for a minute, hold hands, and do treatment. That's how we connect to God, through each other, through love, through understanding, through forgiveness. I forgive that person. Because I'm forgiving myself at the same time for having that reaction to that person on my Sunday holy, holy day. It's my Sunday holy, holy day. Everybody knows, get off my holy, holy day. But we got to look at all the world events that are concerned for our future at this time. And if we do that by looking at ourselves first, then we allow ourselves to move forward. If we look at our past, honestly, we can see that it's always been fine. And I know that. My life experiences told me this too shall pass. This is the blessing. This is the gift. Wait for the transformation. Wait for it. What's God got this? And there's always been in the past conflict. There's always been dis-ease and division. But there's always been growth. There's always been healing through that. There's also been compassion that has existed throughout all of the ages. Look what's happening now. Same gender couples are recognized and accepted more around the world than ever before. Transgender people are publicly embracing their identities now more than ever throughout human history. Look what happened in the news. Love wins. Love wins. Love wins. When we introduce ourselves as different pronouns, and at first I have to admit it was confusing for me, but now I'm all over it. I'm all over it. I love it. Holding on to fear for our future, it's unnecessary. We can break old habits. We can break old chains. We can break old bonds. We can break old ideas. Our time spent should be spent celebrating in the way love wins every single day. Thank you, Neil, for always reminding me that. My husband throws all the good stuff in our life in my face when I'm like this. We all need an advocate like Neil Klassen. He's taken. I believe that love is the solution to every single problem, friends. Any experience that causes conflict is actually an invitation to shift. That's why we get up and move. That's why we sing together. That's why sound comes out and we move together. It changes that vibrational frequency. It's an invitation to shift. And when we dive deeper into love to resolve any situation and all situations that may arise, that allows the shift to occur. Yes? Yes. Conflict allows us to practice radical forgiveness. Radical forgiveness. And when we respond to our challenges with radical forgiveness, we demonstrate the power of forgiveness itself. Our choices serve as an example of how others can radically forgive Every challenge is an invitation to discover how love lives behind it. And I want to remind you, and I want you to celebrate, that when we love ourselves, when I'm up here and I'm transparent, I don't need you to know my story, but I know you love me, and I know that you hold me in that sacred space, even when you are new to the center and you don't know me. I know that if you're feeling love, you're loving yourself, and that you get to receive that love back. So when I'm transparent, when I'm honest, when I'm open, and I'm up here telling you, I didn't know how this morning would work out for me, you know, when I was back here and my husband was rubbing my shoulder saying, love her, it's all going to be okay. I want to remind you that love, when we love ourselves, that shift happens. And when I tell you about that, can it please give you permission to be vulnerable too? Can it please give you permission to share with a loved one and be, or a loved community, and say, I need you to hold me up right now? Because that's why we're here. It's not just about me, but it's all about me. It's not just about you, but it's all about you. It's about us as a whole. And when we flow together in that universal flow, our decision to embrace and inspire, others will do the same. At home, type it in there. Are you feeling me? Loving ourselves out loud attracts people into our life to celebrate us instead of merely tolerating us. Right? Yeah, you know. Loving ourselves with each other aligns us with beautiful opportunities to experience love and peace. When I make love my decision, and it's at the forefront of everything that I do, and I give it all from my heart, when I cross that bridge of challenges, then I'm dancing down that road of joy and happiness, success, and fulfillment. Love is my decision. Is it yours too?
My decision right here and now.
you. Thank you. Spiritual family, we are being called into action today. We have all the power to respond to conflict within us, around us, about us, with love. We can do it. We are doing it. This does not mean that we ignore the spiritual bypass of world events. No. It means taking effective action within our own communities, and that requires us to start loving ourselves. Start loving ourselves. And it's important to find the balance between self-care and giving back to a community in order to give to yourself. And loving people around us is way more constructive use of time rather than complaining. I'm just here to say. We are here to share our experiences with people around us. And as I said, inspire us to do the same. The Science of Mind text says, oh, I love this. The Science of Mind text says, if we look at love long enough, we shall become lovely. For this is the way of love. God is love. If we look, if we gaze longingly at joy, it will make its home in us, and we shall enter its portals and be happy. Isn't that powerful? Love is the grandest healing tool and drawing power on earth, and nothing, not one thing can keep us from the love of God. And I don't know about y'all, but that's a relief to me. It's a huge comfort, and what a joy to know that all is well within the soul. Even those folks that don't know, even those folks that don't accept, are still walking with the love of God. The same God that lives in me is the same God that lives in them, and vice versa. And I want to remind you that love is what we were born with. It was what we were born into. It was what we were born from. And the spiritual journey is the relinquishment. Even when you've reached levels of an ordained minister, even when you support people for decades and decades, it's still yours, that unlearning of fear and the acceptance and putting love back into our hearts. Energy can heal, and that's why love can heal, because love is an energy. When you explore your inner energy, the whole world opens up to you. Deepak Chopra says, when you remember that your internal reference point is your spirit, when you are immune to criticism and unfearful of any challenge, you can harness the power of love and use energy creatively for the experience of affluence and evolution. That's in the 7 spiritual laws of success. When we recognize love, when we embrace love, when we celebrate love, when we embrace God, when we celebrate God, when we accept God, things, good things happen in our life. There's a softness that lands in the soul, in a heart. Your shoulders drop, your chest drops, you're able to breathe, the gut lets go. These are the physical attributes of being in love. Also, the heart beats fast. You can sweat, you can palpate, the palms can get sweaty. Those are all attributes of love. That's God in action. And here to tell us more about God in action, Neal Klassen. Is Neal Klassen with the Science Corner, my favorite part of everything we get to do on a Soul Food Sunday. Welcome to the stage, Neal Klassen.
Thank you. Thank you for those kind words. I'm really not that great, you know.
Yes, he is.
So Shakespeare wrote, "How do I love thee? Let me count the ways." So I decided to count the ways. And it turns out, scientifically and historically, there's 4 to 8 different ways of loving people. And there's so much overlap that it really boils down to 4 different ways. And these are what the Greeks said. There's 4 different ways, 4 different types of love. So the first type is what they call eros, which is the romantic, passionate love. We're all familiar with that. Now, each kind of love can cause great joy and great pain. But eros love is the kind that mostly inspires top 40 songs. It's the kind of love that many of us yearn for, even pushing aside the other kinds of love in pursuit for what this one is. And when we find it, we're lifted up. But when we lose it, we fall down. and I'm not sure if I'm going to pronounce this right, but the next love is what they call phila or philia, which is the love of friends and equals, people like within here. So this is the love. It's good for your health, believe it or not. The touch of a loved one, the philia love, actually lowers your blood pressure. So people living in loving relationships, and I'm not talking about romantic relationships, I'm just talking about loving relationships, have fewer doctor visits, shorter hospital visits, have less pain, and have more positive emotions. Now, all of these positive consequences make us more resilient when hard times come. Then there's what they call storge, which is the love of parents for children, or the other way around. Barb said that we did have a rough year. We've had some family challenges, but we've also had some beautiful experiences. My daughter, who is 30, yeah. Her birthday's today, actually. I've been her dad since she was 4, but for one reason or another, I never officially adopted her. But then she asked me earlier this year, would you adopt me? And I said, sure. So we did. And that adoption came through. So I adopted my daughter as an adult. And that's a parent love for a child and a child love for a parent. And this is kind of the more natural kind of love. It's the most natural. And it's emotive because we simply can't help ourselves. Have you ever held a grandbaby? Or you cannot help yourself. It just, and it pays the least attention to whether that person is really good or bad, right? You know, but we just love. And it's probably genetically wired into us, unlike like romantic love. We're kind of like hardwired to love our children. And the final kind of love, which I think Barb was talking more about today, was what they call agape, which is the love of mankind. So this is what they call the love without any self-benefit. You know, in the Buddhist tradition, it's the central foundation of loving kindness for all mankind. And this kind of love is really important for the process of forgiveness. Forgiving others and forgiving yourselves. That's probably one of the most important things about love. Now, I started with a quote from Shakespeare. I'm going to end my talk today with a quote from Van Halen, who wrote that song, How Do I Know When It's Love? And I'm going to tell you an experience. Now, Melody said last week something about she's always interested in hearing how my mind works, so... So how do I know when it's love? I've been in relationships before. I thought maybe I was in love, but afterwards I wasn't in love. Like, you know what I mean. How did I know I was in love with Barb? I've told her this. So we first met, you know, and we were going together, and we've been around, and I was driving down the road, and they mentioned on the radio that somebody from West Bank had won the lottery. And I said, you know what? If I won the lottery, I wouldn't just give her half and run. I'd stick with her. That's love, man. Think of it. Think of it. How many would you? Oh, here's your half. I'm gone. No. Lover, here's your half, and I'm staying. You can't get rid of me. Thanks very much. Have a great Sunday. Oh, yeah, she asked me, she said, can you sing a love song that's, like, not a love song? What do you mean? Well, you know, a love song that's not romantic love. And I thought, there's a song I know, but I don't know it. Like I know the song, so I'm going to give it a whirl. I think it's a beautiful song. I've never actually played it before, but we're going to give it a whirl. It's by John Lennon.
Love is real. Real is love. Love is feeling. Feeling love. Love is wanting. Touch is love. Love is reaching, reaching love. Love is asking to be loved. Love is you, you and me. Love is knowing what can be. Love is free. Free is love. Love is living. Living love. Love is needing to be.
Thank you.
That's Neal Klassen. What a beautiful song, hey? I want to share a story with you. Albert George McCalla and Margaret Ann Barbara Geary lovingly were married on January 6, 1954, in the province of Alberta, here in Canada. He was 36, she was 16. He was white, she was black. Despite extreme opposition and challenges, they chose to marry and love each other. They married at a time when interracial marriages were not supported, embraced, or even celebrated. They birthed 7 children, they lost 2. They loved deeply, and they fought the same way. They had their challenges, and they chose to love each other. Themselves, their children, their 2 families who had disowned both of them because of their decision to love each other. But most importantly, they had God at the forefront of their relationship and their lives. And for 34 years of marriage, before Margaret died and passed, they stood in their truth, contributing to a wave of marriage equality. They were a couple of marginalized individuals throughout history who fought for their right to be themselves, and they, for me, paved the way for a global shift, and I'm so glad that they did because they were my parents, and I wouldn't be here right now expressing love, being love, if it wasn't for them. They were my examples of love in action. Friends, freedom starts with an individual decision to love out loud. That's why we're here. And I believe, whatever the question, love is the answer. And I invite everyone here today to look for love in every place that you go, in the people that you interact with the events that you go to around the entire world, and most of all, within ourselves. If we want to see more love in the world, we must be willing to be that living example of love in action, yes? This week, one of my vocal students, when we were teaching, she was singing a song, and we both started weeping. And I said to her, "Why are you crying?" I knew why I was crying. And she said, "You know, there's just sometimes when that lyric hits that in the note, and then when the bass came in, and when this happened and that happened." And she said, "I just melted. It all just made sense. I just felt love." That's the symphony of life that we live in. When there's a symphony, there's different sections. There's a brass section, the horn section, there's string section, there's percussion. Love is the conductor of all of it. Love is the conductor that brings it all together. So let me leave you with a couple of questions. 3 questions to ponder. Do you really believe that love is all there is? Do you really believe that love is all there is? Can you trust that all of life is unfolding perfectly? And how would your life look if you believed that love was always in action? Have you told anyone today that you love them? Has anyone told you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you? When we take that love out, we get to express adoration and the treasure and the value of ourselves in others as well. When you believe, when you feel, when you embrace that, now you go and tell someone else. Love is contagious and infectious. It's a good disease to have, if you want to call it disease, because God is love and God is all there is. And that means that we are 100%, not 98, not 50, not one, not none. We are 100% love. So when you love me, and I love you, and I don't have to wait for you to love you, all loving things are lifted and uplifted. Love is energy, it's powerful, and it's transformative. It's changing the world, and it starts at home with each of us in our own backyard. So what will you do to demonstrate love more action? We walk out this door and life happens. Bam, I had a great Sunday. I was inspired. I was uplifted. The music, the talk. We walk out, we get a call, and where we go. Put love on that call, Barbara. Put love in your heart when somebody is challenging you. And when you demonstrate it, send it out in notes of appreciation and text. Reverend Diane just said, I got a love note from Reverend Gwen. How nice it is to be thought of. When I think of people, I try to call them. We send appreciation. Bless the people in your life. Practice radical forgiveness to yourself and others. I want to leave you with this. Believe in the impossible. When you have been given impossible things and you think, no way, believe in the impossible. Whatever you want to accomplish, regardless of how difficult it may seem, believe in yourself. Spirit nudged you to inspire you in a particular way. Trust that that idea is divine. When we remember love wins despite all obstacles, it allows for the bigger change within you to come. I've grown this year. I've grown this year. I didn't want to grow. I didn't want to expand any more consciousness or heart or any of that. But I have grown this year with people I didn't want to grow with. But I have grown in love. And it has been challenging, and it has transformed me. So today I celebrate that because I'm new. I'm different. And I would ask you to consider this in your daily challenges of everyday life, that everything and everyone comes into your life to be loved. The angry neighbor, the flat tire, the diagnosis, the self-doubt, every single thing comes into your life to be loved. So everything and everyone is waiting for our love. So just go out and go get it. Thank you. We have some great things that are happening in our community, and you've heard me share it, and one of them is your love offering and your blessing. Now is the time that we get to rally and share your good, your abundance. If this is your first time, you don't have to, but we will accept it if you want to. We run solely off of your donations, your love offerings, your gifts of love. And I know that we are in a community that is abundant and filled with goodness everywhere, everything, everywhere we look, everywhere we walk, everywhere we live. So there's a couple of things that we say together, and I ask you to repeat after me. I know that my giving blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I give and receive. And together we say, I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. Have you had a good morning? Are you inspired? Come on up, ushers. We'll take a request. I just said to Neil, you want to do another song? We are so grateful for your love. I know that you're heading out today to join Reverend Corrine. I know you'll be there on Thursday at the Royal Anne, and I know that you'll all be here next Sunday, October 1st, with all of your friends and neighbors for Reverend Dr. Kathy Hearn. Forgive me, Dr. Kathy. So up on your feet for more love, more joy, more expression, more God. When love comes knocking at my door,
I say yes.
When love comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
Oh, yeah. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, the freedom, the freedom's calling now. When freedom comes knocking at my door, tap, tap, tap,
I say yes.
At home,
I say yes.
Oh, yeah. When freedom comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
Oh, yeah.
I say yes.
Yeah. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say, you gotta say yes. Here comes the world. The world needs our love. When the world comes knocking at our door, we'll open it up.
I say yes.
And we'll say hello, world.
I say yes.
Let's dance. When the world comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
Oh, yeah.
I say
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. All right. I heard you. Here comes the love. The love's a calling now. When love comes knocking at my door, we will say yes.
I say yes.
Because love is God in action.
I say yes.
Let's dance. When love comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
You are peace and blessings. Thank you, Neal Klassen. See you next week.